Hello and welcome. My name is Mark Horseman, data evangelist with DATAVERSITY. We would like to thank you for joining the current installment of the monthly DATAVERSITY webinar series, Real World Data Governance with Bob Seiner. Bob's topic du jour is executing authority and formalizing accountability for data. Just a couple of points to get us started. Due to the large number of people that attend these sessions, you will be muted during the webinar. If you would like to chat with us or chat with each other, we certainly encourage you to do so. And just to note, the Zoom chat defaults to send to just the panelists, but you may absolutely switch that to network with everybody. For questions, we will be collecting them by the Q&A section. To find the chat and the Q&A panels, you'll see the icons for those features in the bottom middle of your screen. As always, we will send a follow-up email within a couple of business days containing links to the slides, the recording of this session, and any additional information requested throughout the webinar. Now let me introduce to you our speaker for the series, Bob Seiner. Bob is the president and principal of KIK Consulting and Educational Services and the publisher emeritus of the Data Administration Newsletter, tdan.com. Bob was recently awarded the DAMA Professional Award for significant and demonstrable contributions to the data management industry. Bob specializes in non-invasive data governance, data stewardship, and metadata management solutions. And with that, I will hand the floor over to my friend Bob to start his presentation. Hello and welcome.
Hi, Mark. Hi, everybody. Mark, can you see my screen okay?
No, I believe I'm still sharing.
Really? Okay, hold on. Let me share. Replace current share. That would be that, right?
Yes, sir.
I've only done this 150 million times before. Okay, we're sharing. So now we're going to...
I see your Apple News window. There we go. Now I see your slide.
This works for you. Okay. Yep. All right. Thank you, Mark. Thank you for that fantastic introduction. Always appreciated. Happy to have everybody with us today. Thank you again, as I always say, for taking time out of your busy schedules to either attend this live or to watch this on the recording. So this subject is kind of different from a lot of the subjects that I talk about, although we will talk about a lot of the same things. I think if you go back and you look at the webinars that I've done over the years and over the year, you know, usually there's a title of data governance or data stewardship or metadata management in the title of my webinar. But this one, I really wanted to not only kind of get back to basics, but talk about something that is really important in terms of success with a governance program, whether that's data governance, information governance, AI governance. And the title of this webinar is based on the definitions. If you're familiar with the definitions that I'm going to reshare with you again here in a minute, but I talk about data governance as being the execution and enforcement of authority, and I talk about stewardship as being the formalization of accountability. And if you are able to execute and enforce authority and formalize accountability for data in your organizations, the chances are that you, or at least you have a pretty good chance of demonstrating a high level of success with your data governance program. So just before we get started here, I think, Mark, as you had said in the introduction, this is episode number 154 of the Real World Data Governance series. And since I like to kind of go with the theme of the holiday, I just thought that I'd have this kind of gangsta looking turkey here, looking at everybody and telling you not to wing it, govern your data, don't do data governance per se, but govern your data. And one of the ways that you're going to do that is through executing authority over the data and formalizing accountability for the data. So let me go into that before, where did my screen go? There we go. Before I get started, what I would like to do is just tell you a little bit about some things that are going on now and that are coming up in the near future. As you know, this Real World Data Governance webinar series takes place on the third Thursday of every month. And next month, I'm going to be talking about the convergence of the governance of structured data and the governance of unstructured data, and how artificial intelligence doesn't really care where it gets its data from. But if your organization is starting down the path of implementing AI solutions, integrating AI into the things that you do, at some point, you're going to be looking at not only the structured data, the bits and bytes in tables and databases and those types of things, but you're also going to be looking at unstructured data as well. So next month on the third Thursday of the month, right before the Christmas holiday, I'm going to be talking about structured and unstructured data governance excellence. It's a topic that I am very interested in, and that you will see webinars on that subject in 2025 as well as part of this series. I also want to let you know that I will be speaking at the probably the biggest and best event, or one of the best events of the year, taking place in just a couple of weeks in Washington, D.C., and that is the DGIQ East Conference, Data Governance and Information Quality Conference, and it's now an AI governance conference as well as a Women in Data event. So during that event in Washington, D.C., I'll be doing two sessions. I'll be doing a tutorial, which I will talk about building an effective AI and data governance joint framework. And I'm also going to be doing a session with a client of mine in the federal government space about all the fun that we're having resetting their data governance council, a council that has been in place for years. So if you're in the DC area, or if you can make it to the DC area, I think there's still seats available. Would love to see you in Washington, DC. Just also wanted to add that I just received the invitation yesterday to speak at the Enterprise Data Governance Online event from DATAVERSITY. And you can mark this on your calendar for January 22nd. That's typically a great online event. And I'll be talking about the same subject to a degree that I'll be doing in the tutorial at the DGIQ conference in a couple of weeks. I talk a lot about non-invasive data governance. I've written a couple of books on non-invasive data governance, just one called Non-Invasive Data Governance, the other one, Non-Invasive Data Governance Strikes Again. I've been talking about this a little bit recently, but it's basically set now that in 2025, there will be a third book in the series called Non-Invasive Data Governance Unleashed. And it's going to focus more on the future of AI and stewardship and how they relate to implementing effective non-invasive data governance programs. I have a couple of learning plans, actually three learning plans that are available through DATAVERSITY. If you're interested in learning more about my consulting business, you can find it at kikconsulting.com. KIK stands for Knowledge is King. And beyond all of these things that I'm working on in my spare time, I'm also an adjunct faculty member at Carnegie Mellon University here in my hometown of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, in their executive ed CDAI certificate program. So love to talk to you about that if that's something that will interest you as well. So what am I going to talk about today? So we're going to talk about these executing authority and formalizing accountability for data. As you know, one of the ways that you're going to be able to tell whether or not your program is being successful is if you're getting people to do the right things at the right time with the right data. And I talk about the Data Governance Bill of Rights, but you're going to need to be able to execute authority in order to do that. And you're also going to need to be able to formalize accountability for people across the organization that define and produce and use data as part of their daily jobs. How can we formalize what they're doing without going and making it feel like you're hitting them over the head with a stick and you're giving them something that they potentially didn't already have? So I'll talk about formalizing accountability through building a structure for your organization that allows you to do so. We'll talk about aligning authority with organizational objectives. That's something that's it seems like the buzzword of the day is data strategy, even more than AI and even more than data governance, is every organization seems to be focusing on building data strategies. And the first thing that they want to do is they want to align the things that they're doing with the objectives that are being outlined in those strategies. So I'll talk about aligning authority with your organizational objectives. We'll talk about empowering those people in the organization who you might refer to as data owners. I usually don't use the term owner because I think it doesn't imply what we're trying to do with stewards, who are people who are basically have a relationship to the data, who are accountable for what they do with the data. Data owners, data ownership is it's my data. I can do with it what I want. No, the organization owns the data. But we'll talk about how to empower these people who are the owners or the decision makers around the data and the people who are defining, producing, and using data as their parts of their regular job. And then as I have time at the end of the webinar today, I want to share with you some examples of different organizations that have really taken the authority and the accountability position to heart with their data governance programs. So as I normally do, I share some definitions with you, and I think it's really appropriate to talk about the definitions because these are what the title of this webinar is based on. And if you've been with me and you've been attending these webinars over the years, you've seen that my definitions for governance stewardship and what a steward is keep getting shorter and shorter. People don't seem to have a tolerance for long definitions. But the truth is that data governance, the best way that I can say what that really means is that it's the execution and enforcement of authority over data. The government doesn't come to us, our suppliers, our partners don't come to us and ask us to do the right thing with the data. They ask us to make certain that we're providing good quality data, that we're executing, enforcing authority and rules over how we're making data private, how we're improving data shareability within the organization, but falling within the rules. So I know that that definition of data governance has some teeth to it. And that's the intention of it, is to have some teeth. So get people to sit up in their chairs when you talk about what data governance is. Because truth is, no matter what approach you take, whether it's a command and control kind of top down or a field of dreams kind of traditional approach of if you build it, they will come, or a non-invasive approach to data governance, at the end of the day, you need to execute and enforce authority over your data. Data stewardship, and I talk about this all the time, it is the formalization of accountability for data. There's already people in your organization that define, produce, and use data as part of their job. They're already being held potentially informally accountable for the things that they do, but stewardship is truly the formalization of that accountability for data. And just in the same vein, you know, a data steward is basically somebody who has a relationship to the data as a definer, producer, or user of the data, and they're now being held formally accountable for that relationship. So just keep those definitions in mind, because the execution and of executing authority and formalizing accountability for data is what this webinar is all about. I want to just expand on those definitions a little bit here as well, because I use the words authority, accountability, enforcement, and what it means to be formal. And I don't want to go through these in too much detail. You can read them, but basically I highlighted the things that I feel are important. The authority being that power or right to tell somebody to do something or to make decisions. And so at the end of the day, we need to exercise, we need to execute authority, because we just can't allow it to be a free-for-all. I'm going to share with you an operating model that has a path to making decisions within the organization, but executing authority is a big part of data governance. The accountability is basically the obligation to do those things that are based, at least in my definition, based on your relationship to the data. If you use data, then you should know the rules associated with how you can use that data, who you can share that data with, and so on and so forth. But I figured it's good to just at least quickly share some definitions of what those four words are. Because one of the things that I find is that in most organizations, there's already accountability for data, but it's very informal. And if we can go from informal to formal accountability for data, that's going to be less threatening than hitting people over the head and assigning them new roles and telling them that they have all new things to do. So again, I'll embrace that subject a little bit more as we go forward here. So just real quickly, the execution and the enforcement of authority are these things that you see on your screen: establishing oversight, monitoring adherence, enforcing compliance, assigning — I don't really like the word assigning, I should probably take that out of there — but really recognizing accountability for data governance. Let's recognize those people in the organization who are defining, producing, and using data, and let's help them to do it better without making them feel as though being a steward is now three steps over the things that they're already presently doing. Because everybody is already busy 100%, 150% of the time. If they're being assigned into a new role and they're given more responsibility, their first question is going to be, where am I going to find time to do these things that you're adding to what I presently do? the formalization of accountability for data. Again, these are the just some quick statements that kind of stand behind the whole concept of what does it mean to formalize accountability that people in the organization potentially already have. All right, let's jump into the topics that we're going to address today. The first one being defining the clear lines of authority. And so in order to define the clear lines of authority, I wanted to share with you some things that you should consider along the way. And some of those things are identifying key data governance roles, defining decision-making and authority levels within the organization, all of these things. I'm going to jump into these subjects one by one and just give a little bit of background on what I'm talking about here. So when I first talk about defining clear lines of authority, one of the first steps, and I've found this in most of the governance programs that I work with, is that we need to define roles and responsibilities. We need to define roles. And if you've seen the framework that I share and you've seen the operating model, which I'm going to share with you here in a minute, there are five different levels of roles within an organization. And I've seen organizations put different names to these, and you might have different names for some of these roles. But at the very top of the organization, the senior most leadership is your executive role. And then you've got your strategic role. That's where your strategies are being developed. They're really viewing things from an organizational, cross-organizational perspective. Then there's a tactical level, which really is, you know, it's the definition, the production, the usage of data across different business functions. So where people are looking at data that's being used in multiple places across the organization, I consider that to be the tactical level roles. I'll talk more about that in a second. But then the operational becomes once we get within a specific business function. That's the operational roles. That's the operational stewards that I talk often about. And then there's the support level roles. And that is anybody from IT to your human resources group, to your finance group, anybody who is basically has a partnership with data governance to help the organization to govern everything, govern people, govern finance, govern locations, and all of those types of things. So if you've attended my webinars in the past, you've probably seen this operating model quite a few times. And so you'll see on the left-hand side, there's all those support level roles that I'm talking about. Again, we're looking at how are we going to use these roles to execute authority and to formalize accountability. We've got to understand that we've got partners across the organization who are already governing, not necessarily governing data. Even your project management folks are governing projects. You've got people under all these different categories listed under data partners. The support function within the organization, the support level, the support roles are really important when you're creating your operating model of roles and responsibilities. Down the right-hand side of the model, you can see I've got the executive level, the strategic level, tactical, and operational. And the amount of space within each of the levels of the operating model, they mean something. In most organizations, they're looking to push as much of the decision-making as they can down to the operational level. That's why there's more space in the operational level. Then once an issue starts to pertain to multiple business functions, you can see there's less space in the tactical level. Those are the domain stewards, or the, I guess you could call them data owners, perhaps, if that's where you define that role within your organization. Above that is the strategic level. That's your data governance council or data governance committee. And above that is even the executive level. And if you ask, why is the executive level just a tower sticking out of the top? Because if you follow this escalation and approval path, very rarely, if ever, does something actually get extended up to the executive level to make a decision. That's why in many organizations, they create a council level at the strategic level. So again, I'm not going to go into a tremendous amount of detail about this operating model, but identifying the key governance roles is an important piece of executing authority and formalizing accountability for data across your organization. So what I did was I blew that diagram up a little bit in case you couldn't see it, the size that it was being shown before. But I just really, one thing that kind of gets lost in this diagram is that second arrow, which is, as you can see, starts at the operational level, goes up to the tactical, up to the strategic, but it doesn't extend up to the executive level. We need to be able to execute authority and enforce accountability and formalize accountability at all levels of the organization. And the fact is, people already have responsibilities for data. We just need to know who those people are. And let's focus first on formalizing the things that they're already tasked with doing, instead of making it feel like we're handing them many more tasks, things that are over and above some of the things that they're presently doing. So when we think about how many decisions get made at the different levels of the organization, here's just some numbers that I have used. I don't know how accurate they are in many organizations, but you know, typically we're going to take less than 1% of our decisions up to the executive level. Certainly there are decisions being made at the executive level, but not day-to-day data governance type, data governance related issues. So basically we don't extend the authority levels for decision-making around day-to-day governance to our executive levels. And you may find it different within your organization. A lot of it has to do with the governing style and the governing structure within your organization. That strategic level, if you notice, that was only about 10% of the total space within the pyramid that I just shared. And so typically organizations like to resolve cross-functional decisions at that tactical level. That's why the role of the domain steward is such an important role when it comes to authority and accountability for data across the organization. Again, the percentage for the tactical is, well, it's whenever a business problem impacts multiple business functions, you know, typically it would be good to have somebody who's looking at this across the organization rather than just specifically within one business function. Because at the one business function, that's the operational level. So that's whenever the decisions impact just a single business function, that would be that level of authority within the organization. And then the support of the governing partners who probably already have levels of authority based on what their role is. For example, information security is governing, and some of the rules are ULES, are based on the important role of your information security group. So defining clear levels of authority needs to be mapped to an operating model or to the roles and responsibilities that you've defined within your organization. All right, so let's talk about recognizing authority within specific business functions within your organization. And I have some notes here. I'm just trying to find my page with my notes on it. So we understand that, you know, first of all, if we're going to take a non-invasive approach to governance, we need to recognize that there's already people doing things, that there's already governance taking place in your organization, even if you don't have a formal data governance program. There are already people who are defining data, producing data, and using data as part of their job. And most likely, out of those three, the usage of the data is the one that's scrutinized most heavily. But if we're going to implement governance across the organization, we need to recognize the appropriate roles of people who are both defining data and producing data to help us to get to the point where we're using data more effectively across the organization. There's already people that are accountable for making decisions, and they're accountable for the decisions that they make. There's already people that are accountable for getting the right people involved at the appropriate time. So the one thing we should do is, instead of, again, setting up roles and assigning people things that they may not already have, the key word here is recognize. Let's recognize people for what they do. Let's help them to do that in a more effective manner across the organization. And let's do it in such a way that we're not making them feel as though we're handing them a tremendous additional amount of responsibility in what they're doing. Again, people are busy all the time. We try to introduce more things to what they're doing, and they're going to push back. It doesn't mean that data governance means that the non-invasive approach means that there won't be any additional tasks. It just means that we might be involving these people who are recognized as being stewards more often, or recognizing them more appropriately and as we need them within the organization. And the truth is that people have always been accountable. I mean, just to ask your leadership, they're going to tell you that people in the organization are accountable for what they do. But the problem is that that accountability is often informal. And if we can go from informal to formal, it's going to be a lot less threatening, a lot less invasive to them. So again, the move from the informal to the formal, be very clear in your roles and responsibilities. And instead of assigning people, at least at the beginning, try to recognize those people who are already doing some of the things that you need as you're defining the roles within your governance program. All right, so another important aspect of executing authority and formalizing accountability is ensuring that leadership endorses governance, the governance authority. And that's a problem in a lot of organizations, is that the senior leadership doesn't necessarily get that involved in endorsing the authority or helping to define who in the organization is going to have the responsibility for making what decisions. So oftentimes we focus on leadership, not only supporting, sponsoring, and understanding what the heck we're trying to do with data governance, but I really like that word of endorse. We're going to need our senior leadership to endorse authority. They're going to do it through a strategic alignment with the organizational goals. And you'll see that'll be a resonating theme on some of the slides that are coming up, because everybody and everywhere is trying to align what they are doing with organizational goals. The problem is, with so many activities, they're all vying for the same type of attention. And so the closer that you can align the things that you're doing with the organizational goals, the more likelihood that the people at the highest level of your organization, those who need to endorse governance authority, are going to pay attention. So improve data-driven decision-making outcomes, establish governance as a priority in leadership communications. They should stand behind the things that we are doing, that the governance program is doing. And the best way to get your leadership to endorse governance authority is to demonstrate value, to establish this as a priority in the way that they even communicate with people, and to involve your leadership in approving and endorsing and standing behind the roles and responsibilities that I just talked about. Communicating the roles consistently. Again, I want to share with you some of the actions that are typically necessary to communicate the authority roles consistently. The first one starts with clearly defining your roles around data governance, whether that's through a charter, whether that's through the standards that you're producing, the policies that you're producing. But you want to make certain that's one of the actions that you're taking in order to communicate the authority roles consistently. Define the roles well, make sure that they're being incorporated into regular meetings and reports that are coming out, aligning your roles with your objectives, and using, one of the things that I find is using visual aids, like that pyramid diagram that I shared with you before. How does authority take place? How do we get to the point where we can make an effective decision within our organization? So using visual aids and workflows to explain your authority structure takes you a long way towards communicating authority roles consistently as a way to, again, get you to the point where you're executing and enforcing authority and formalizing accountability for data across the organization. All right, the next subject that I want to address is formalizing accountability through building of the structure within your organization. And some of the actions that are necessary to do that include defining the roles with measurable responsibilities, establishing metrics for accountability, creating documentation, all of these things. And what I want to do is I want to walk through these one by one. But the truth is that if you don't have structure, if you don't have an operating model, if you don't have clearly defined roles and responsibilities, it's going to be very hard to formalize anything within your organization. So I'd start with defining the roles and responsibilities, recognizing the people into the roles, and then taking some of these actions to move forward with how you forward or formalize your accountability through the structure. So let's start with defining roles with measurable responsibilities. Well, you've probably heard me say before, if you've attended these webinars, there's a bunch of things that I like to say kind of ad nauseum a little bit probably, but I say that everybody in the organization is a data steward and that the organization should get over that. So anybody in the organization who has a relationship to the data that's being held formally accountable for that relationship is a steward, and organizations should get over that fact. It's truly the only way to have data governance cover your entire organization. Instead of assigning a handful of people, let's recognize those people who are already stewards. I also talk about that that organizations are already governing data. Organizations that have been around for a few years that have databases and systems and people and process, there's already governance taking place. So there's already governance around data that's taking place. We need to recognize that and then formalize that as part of our process. And I always say that the data will not govern itself. So we need to make certain that we know we need to define the roles. We need to define measurable responsibilities for these people, help people to understand that these are responsibilities that they already have, help them to recognize that this doesn't, that being part of the governance program doesn't necessarily change that. So again, a lot of it comes down to our core message of what we're sharing with people across the organization. Establishing performance metrics for accountability, that's another way to formalize accountability through the structure. Just tie the metrics directly to what you're doing in data governance. Tie the things that you're doing in data governance specifically to those business objectives of the organization, the strategic goals of the organization. So once we've identified who those people are who are accountable, let's find a way to measure what the effectiveness of their accountability is. And find ways to, as that evolves and changes across the organization, let's find ways to be able to report that to the organization. How effective is the recognition of stewards within the organization? And how is that getting us to the point where we've actually formalized accountability for what people do with data across the organization? You know, create formal documentation. And in many of the organizations I work with, there's a lengthy document that supports that operating model diagram. It clearly outlines the roles and the tasks. And not only that, people have taken that operating model and kind of built it into, if you're familiar with RACI matrices and things like that, what task is responsible for taking what action at what point within a process? So we need to define clear accountability for all data activities throughout each step of every process. Standardized procedures, ensure responsibilities. Again, these are ways to create formal documentation for data duties that are going to help you to formalize accountability, which is part of what we're talking about today, the executing authority and formalizing accountability for data. Link the accountabilities to strategic data objectives or even just strategic business objectives within the organization. You know, one of the ways to do that is to just kind of build them into the activities that are taking place across the organization. Instead of saying, we need to implement a new governance process or procedure, let's look at the existing processes that we have. Let's look at the existing project plans that we have. And let's integrate governance into and make certain that governance is being addressed to ensure that there's accountability along every step of the process. So ensuring accountability enhances governance outcomes and enhances decision-making effectiveness as well. And again, it's important to formalize accountability through the structure that you've defined for roles and responsibilities within your organization. And then it obviously, it just becomes important to assure that you can formalize accountability through structure. You should monitor that. Monitor the adherence to the accountability frameworks that you have within the organization, and be willing and be able to change your framework, change your operating model if there's changes to the business. Don't just stick with one and stay with it throughout and not be open and willing to adjust it as your business changes, as the industry changes, as whatever it is you're trying to govern changes. All right, I said I was going to talk a little bit about aligning authority with organizational objectives, and I'm going to try to do that real quickly here. What are some of the ways? So first of all, aligning to the things that are important in the organization, I can't tell you how that's become a part, or maybe you already know, that's how that's become a part of data strategies everywhere. I've talked to two consulting companies this week that I'm potentially looking to partner with who have data strategy practices. Even in the Carnegie Mellon program that I talked about earlier, that I'm an adjunct faculty member for, the focus is on data strategies. It seems as though data strategies, as I said earlier, have overtaken even AI and overtaken data governance as being things that organizations are talking about. So these are the things that are necessary if an organization is going to execute and enforce authority over data and formalize accountability. We need to connect the authority to what the goals of the organization are. We need to, let me go through each of these and talk about each of these individually. All right, so let's talk about some of the ways to align authority with the organizational objectives. And one of the ways is to connect the authority to the strategic business goals. So look at the high priorities from the organization, look at the performance metrics, the things that are being measured and evolved, and the people that are going to need to be involved in helping your organization to get there. And recognize those roles. And again, set up a responsible decision-making method within your organization. How are you going to escalate issues within your organization in order to get decisions to be made? So we know that we want to get the right people involved in making the right decisions about what's important in the organization. And in order to do that, we need to make certain that we are well aware of what those strategic objectives of the organization are. So connecting authority to strategic business goals is an important aspect of aligning authority with your organizational objectives. This slide says some of the same things. Again, make certain that your data governance program, for all the things that you're trying to do, make certain that when you're asking people to do things within the organization, it's supporting the things that they're trying to achieve in their mission and goals. I see organizations, I'm a very much a big believer of business glossaries and data dictionaries and data catalogs and those types of things. But we got to think about the activities that we're asking people to do within the organization and what they have time to be able to do. And if we're asking them to do things that they do not see any clear connection between the things that they're being asked to do and the missions and goals of the organization, that's something that we need to correct. We need to get them to understand why improving the definition of data is going to help us to meet our organizational goals. Why focusing on critical data elements and the quality and the value of the data in the critical data element fields are going to be are aligned with our mission critical objectives. Again, we want to make certain if we're going to execute authority and formalize accountability for data, we're not asking people to do things that they do not understand the value that is going to come from those things. So ensure that your governance asks and that your governance activities align with things that are important to people across the organization. That's one way to get them to pay attention. I can almost assure you that if it doesn't, if they're questioning what you're asking them to do in the relationship to what their management is asking them to do, the chances are they're not going to prioritize the things that are mostly governance related. Integrate authority into the data-driven processes, embed authority into how decisions are being made. Clearly define in your operating model who gets to make decisions for what and how you're going to validate and vet decisions up through your operating model. Ensure that the authority is there to back these decisions that are being made. That's why I mentioned earlier, not only do we need to get our executive leadership to support, sponsor, and understand, but they need to endorse the use of authority. I can tell you of several organizations I'm working with now that I question their creation of policy and directives and those types of things, because I'm not certain that there is any point where there is somebody within that organization who's going to stand behind and be the authority to let these things take place within the organization. So we need to integrate authority into our data-driven decision processes, because otherwise a lot of these policies and things that are being created may just be paperwork. They may just be stuck in a binder, sitting on a virtual shelf somewhere that somebody may not read. But make the things that you're asking people to do relevant to the things that they're presently doing, and help them to understand that we need their assistance, that we're not asking them to do things that are just random data management activities. These things are all tied to things that are very important to the organization, like the organizational objectives. Promote alignment through executive sponsorship. Like I said, it's not enough now for them just to support, sponsor, and understand. Oftentimes it takes that endorsement and that promotion of the executive leadership to make certain that that the appropriate level of authority is in place and that we're getting the appropriate people to be accountable for making the decisions. You know, they align the executive goals with the governance objectives. They champion governance through, you know, through making this more visible at their level of the organization. I've always said that it's the number one best practice in an organization is that if your senior leadership do not support, sponsor, and understand, and now talking about endorse authority across the organization, your organization is going to be at risk for being able to make and stay and keep with and stand behind decisions that are being made across your organization. Regularly take a look at the authority and make certain that the appropriate people have the appropriate authority. Make certain that the authority aligns as your business and your governance priorities are changing within your organization. Make certain that you take a look at that authority and you review it from time to time. Because organizations are dynamic, their data governance programs can be dynamic. Make certain that you have the appropriate people in the positions of authority in order to make certain that decisions that are being, governing decisions that are being made are being stood behind and that they're being executed appropriately and they're being enforced appropriately across the organization. The last real subject I want to talk about before I kind of jump quickly through some examples of where organizations have executed authority and formalized accountability and how those things have helped organizations is the empowering of these people that we call data owners, if we call them that, and the stewards, the people who are basically have relationships to data that are being held formally accountable for those relationships. I don't know if you've ever looked up the definition of what a steward is in the dictionary, but a definition of a steward is somebody who takes care of something for somebody else. I've mentioned this in previous webinars. I drove by a church recently in my community that said, had a sign outside that said, "We are a stewardship community. We are here to help each other." Stewards are not owners. Owners, you know, people, when they hear the term owner, think it's they can make the decisions that they want because they own the data. Well, the better term may be data domain steward, somebody who is a subject matter expert and potentially an authority over a certain type of data across the organization. So we need to empower our owners and stewards, and I want to spend a couple minutes talking about some different ways that you can go about doing that. So one of the first ways to empower your data owners and your stewards is to provide them with some level of decision-making power. Empower them to be able to make decisions, enable the stewards to work together to come to decisions that are going to be acceptable across the organization. But we've got to take these stewards, and stewards are not just the pawns of the organization. They're tasked with making decisions every day based on the data that they have in front of them. They shouldn't be the operational data stewards who are working within a business function or business area should not have the authority to make decisions that are going to impact the entire organization unless they have knowledge as to what that impact will be. That's why there's different levels in that pyramid diagram that I shared. There's the operational stewards at the operational level, the tactical cross-business function stewards at the tactical level. We need to enable the stewards in the organization to not feel like they're just pawns there to follow the rules. Help them to understand what levels of authority they have and when it's appropriate for them to make decisions. And when they're going to make a decision that's going to potentially impact people across the organization, when do we need to move along that arrow that I showed in the operating model and escalate it up to the tactical level and then escalate it up to the strategic level if that's what needs to take place in order to make a decision? Equip the data owners with necessary tools and resources. not only from a technical governance and analytical tool perspective, but also with the metadata repository or a data catalog or an AI catalog, which is something I wrote about within the last week, is how AI is now looking at data and information, structured and unstructured data, and they're not caring where they get the data from. Some of those tools that we can be providing to people who are leveraging and using AI for the corporate benefit is an AI catalog as well. So make sure that we're equipping these people who are the data owners and the stewards with the tools and the resources that they need in order to help them to make the appropriate decisions. And by all means, you can't expect that these people that you're recognizing as stewards across the organization, that they know what it means to, and I'm going to say this lightly, to do steward stuff. We need to help them to get them to recognize themselves as being stewards of the data, recognize that the activities that they're presently working on or things that they presently do that have to do with defining, producing, and using data, that they understand what's being expected of them as stewards of that data. You know, being assigned a data steward, it always feels like it's over and above. It's almost as though nobody wants to be assigned to be a data steward. But if we go to them and we help to educate them and train them based on the things that they're presently doing, they're much more willing to sit forward in their chair and listen to what you have to say, because you're not handing them anything new. You're helping them to do things that they already do and do it in a more efficient and effective way for the organization. Certainly training to enhance stewardship effectiveness is a big, lost my place here, is very important when it comes to getting our stewards to do the appropriate things within the organization. The next thing is that we need to recognize and reward effective stewardship in the organization. And whether that's public recognition or it's private recognition, I have found that in a lot of the meetings that I'm in one of the projects that I'm on, there's always time that is left to call out recognizing people for doing good work, recognizing stewards for doing good work, recognizing the people who are in positions to execute authority and to formalize accountability, call out when they're doing good work. So always recognize and reward effective data stewardship. That's just another way of empowering your data owners and data stewards on your route to executing authority and formalizing accountability for data across the organization. People want to be recognized. And it is good. There's many ways to be able to do that. And as things change within the organization, we need to make certain that we call out those people who have played a positive role in the positive changes that are coming around data management and data governance in the organization. And foster that culture of data responsibility. I know most organizations, at least before the last couple of years, have not viewed themselves as being data centric. People don't go into work in the morning thinking about, oh, what am I going to do with data and how am I going to impact improving the effectiveness and the efficiency around the use of data within the organization. So these things like data literacy, they don't take place on them by themselves. It requires having somebody to foster that culture of data responsibility. And here's just a couple of ways that I suggest doing it, or that I think you should consider when you're looking to foster that data culture, is encourage accountability, promote transparency, build trust, empower teams, do all of these things. And you'll go a good way towards making those people that you're recognizing as the stewards and the owners of the data, making them responsible, holding them accountable, formalizing things that they're presently doing instead of making it feel like we're handing them all these new things to do. All right, we've got a couple minutes left, Mark. I'm just going to quickly go through these and then see if we have any questions from the stuff that I've talked about today. Again, I think this is a unique subject. Instead of talking about specifically governance and stewardship, talking about getting to the point where we can execute authority and formalize accountability for data and do it in such a way that people don't feel as though we're infringing on the things that they that they're presently doing and getting in the way of them being effective. So let me run through a bunch of examples of authority and accountability. Then I'll turn it over to you, Mark, for some questions. Just want to share with you, and I did end up writing some client names next to some of these. I don't want to go into the specifics of the clients, but you know, look at the ways, look where authority and accountability fit into these statements of the success of these organizations. You know, improving data consistency by using clear authority and accountability, reducing errors through accountability, enhancing data access via governance, accelerating data projects with accountability. That's just a couple examples or four examples of organizations that have taken authority and accountability to heart as they built out their governance programs. Some case studies include a retail team, and you can look at the statistics here. They increased sales by 15% over a period of time just by getting people in the organization by more clearly defining accountability for the data and the processing of the data within the organization. You know, bank accountability, you know, focusing on compliance, a reduction in compliance-related issues. Again, I don't want to read all of these to you, but I can it does demonstrate to you that, you know, those organizations that get serious about executing authority and formalizing accountability, again, my definitions of data governance and stewardship, they're able to demonstrate success within these organizations. And if you want to talk to me about any of these, please feel free to reach out to me. I'll be happy to talk to you about them. Again, some real life data governance challenges that were solved in the public sector and the financial sector. I think they understand, even if they don't like my definition of executing and enforcing authority over the management of the data, but they understand that that has to be the goal of their data governance program, gives them the ability to solve some of these challenges that are listed on the screen in front of you. I think I have one more page of authority through governance frameworks, how banks have empowered stewards, how a healthcare provider was able to enforce certain compliance rules through a structured governance framework like the one I shared with you earlier. Again, authority through governance frameworks, build authority, the execution and enforcement of authority, and build the formalization of accountability into what you do. With your governance program, increasing quality, boosting compliance rates. Again, please take a look at these slides sometime. I know I'm going through these really quickly, but if you'd like to talk about these use cases, or if you have a use case of your own, I'd love to talk to you about it. So I know, Mark, we're right at the end of the time here. This is an important subject. Even though it doesn't have data governance or data stewardship or metadata in the title, that's the implied focus of what we talked about today. We need to execute authority. We need to formalize accountability for data in order for our governance program to be successful. I talked about defining those lines of authority, formalizing accountability, aligning this with the things that are important to the organization, empowering those people in the organization who are in a position to help you to execute and enforce authority and formalize accountability for data. And with that, Mark, I am going to turn it back to you to see if we have any questions.
We got some great questions here, and we got one question here that is kind of an issue that a friend of mine is having at his workplace, but it's like the questioner is not my friend in question, but they're asking, could some examples be given as to the kinds of decisions which operational level data stewards should be empowered to make? Say, what would a data engineering development manager who is also a data steward for the domain his team develops data assets for be making data stewarding decisions on? And I'm fascinated to hear how you tackle this question, Bob, because I'll bring it to my friend as well.
Oh, it's hard. It's a great question. So thank you for the question. They should be making decisions that aren't going to impact other business functions within the organization. So if they're making an engineering, a technical drawing, a data decision for the data that's going to impact the marketing, the sales, impact the effectiveness of using that tool in collaboration with other tools, yeah, they shouldn't be there to just make the decisions themselves. So I think that in order to kind of clear up that question as to, well, when do we take it to a higher level or when do we resolve it ourselves, it should all focus on, is this going to impact people across the organization other than the just the specific function that I'm working within? And if the answer to that question is yes, then if you're making a decision at the operational level without looking at what the entire organization needs, you're putting yourself at risk.
I love that answer. And that's exactly what I've been telling my friend too.
Well, you know, smart people, we think alike, right?
There we go. sort of related to that, what kinds of relationships with data should people have in order to be eligible to be, they say appointed as a data steward, but I know you'll say recognized.
I don't like appointed. Appointed feels like being assigned. You know what? If people use, so just think, you know, if you just use those three actions, the definition, the production, and the usage of data, if they're defining data that's going to be used in, even in just within their business area, or data that's going to be used across the organization, they should be involving the appropriate people and they should be paying specific attention to providing a formal definition that can be used across the organization. If they're producing data, they need to be thinking about downstream. That the joke I always say is that more people were born on 010101 than any other day, because the default for the data production, it started with a crap date that didn't mean anything to anybody. People need to be accountable for producing data or just bringing data into the organization and making certain that that data is well-defined and is accessible to those people that need it. And certainly the no-brainer is around the people that use the data. I mean, these are, if they're expected, you're not going to take a room of 50 people and split it in half and say, okay, that room of 50 people, all of you use sensitive data. Only 25 of you are going to need to protect it. The truth is, just by your relationship to the data, there are certain levels of accountability that can be formalized without making it feel like you're hitting people over the head. It's a way to get people involved by saying, you know what, you're already doing this. Let's help you to do it better.
Well, and I love that, the terms of being accountable for your relationship to data. Like, that just makes sense too.
Well, and if we can do that, I know people poke fun at the fact that I say everybody is a data steward, get over it. Well, I would say almost everybody in your organization does have a relationship to the data. There's probably going to be more users than definers and more producers than definers. But if you use data that's sensitive, it's not something that you opt into or opt out of. It's based on your relationship. You are a steward if you're being held formally accountable for that relationship. Again, awesome. It comes back to the title of the webinar here, which, you know, I think is pretty strongly worded.
We have the million-dollar question here, which could probably be a webinar on its own. You mentioned data literacy. How do you define data literacy in simple terms?
There's a lot more. There's a lot smarter people who have defined that than myself. But I say it's the ability to speak with data, to the ability to be able to communicate with data. Just like literacy anywhere for any language is being able to communicate. So being able to not only tell stories about the data, but tell stories with the data. So if you can improve your ability to be able to do that, and that takes thorough understanding of the data, then I think you're getting closer to becoming data literate. So it is the ability to be able to communicate effectively with data.
I think we have time for one last question. Bob, how do you overcome resistance? What strategies do you recommend for overcoming resistance when introducing formalized accountability and authority in data governance, especially in organizations that are used to a more decentralized approach?
Well, when people have relationships to the data, and they acknowledge that they have relationships to the data. The way I get over the resistance is say, look, we're not giving you something that you don't already have. We're helping you to understand that your relationship to the data is important, and we're going to hold you accountable for it. Again, I said, this isn't an opt-in or opt-out thing. People can't say, you know, I hear what you say about being a data steward, and I don't want to do that. Well, you can't do that. You can't say that if you're using data that has rules associated with it. You are a steward. So that's why I said, we need people to get over that fact and say that, you know, potentially everybody in the organization that has a relationship to the data is involved in improving the governance of that data.
Yeah, and that would be a wonderful thing to chat about during conference live if you're in the DC area in December. I hope folks out in audience land can make it to join both Bob and I. And that's all we have time for today. So thank you very much, Bob. Thank you, chat, for the amazing questions and being so energetic all session. And we look forward to seeing you next time. Thanks again, Bob.
All right. Thanks, everybody. And have a happy Thanksgiving if you celebrate. Take care. Thanks.